ladies don't Nigerian ladies always have that transport fee.
Yeah.
But you know, I've been in that situation
before. I really need to.
Hello, welcome back to my YouTube channel.
Yeah.
So this is the second episode of our relationship chat series. And I still have my friend Victor with me.
Hello guys.
So I hope you enjoyed the first episode. And if you have not dropped your comment, don't drop your comment, don't drop your suggestion.
Like and subscribe. Yeah.
If you're a returning subscriber, please always like, comment and share my videos. If this is your first time of viewing my videos, please click on the subscribe button.
Tell your friends,
it's your only way of helping me grow my channel. The first question I'll be asking Victor is, how important is money in a relationship?
Ego, money is very important. It's the crux of life. The peak of life. Mm-hmm. Like Yoruba would say, oh, ni keke in rere.
Money is the bicycle of gospel.
So money really, it's how we say in a relationship. If either of the partner does not have money, there will be a lack back.
Yes, so let me comment. When we say money is important in a relationship, it doesn't necessarily mean you have to have millions before you go into a relationship.
Yeah.
Don't get us wrong. As humans, if I don't have money, I won't enjoy myself.
Mm-hmm.
And not enjoying myself is not, it's not that I have money to afford luxury, like basic things of life, like as a single person, as a single lady or guy, there are sometimes you get bored and you just feel like, okay, let me take myself to the cinema and watch this movie. Mm-hmm. Let me take myself out and get this thing for me. So now imagine yourself in a relationship with someone. When you guys don't take yourself out, when there's no money in the relationship will get boring.
Mm-hmm.
And there are sometimes you can just wake up and say, okay, just tell your partner, let's go out and watch movies. Mm-hmm. You can just go out and say, okay, I got this thing for you. Like, all those things makes the relationship interesting.
Exactly.
You can't. Remember, we're not saying that you have to be able to afford an iOS phone. You have to be able to travel out of the country. No, there's some basic things you need money for in a relationship. Yes, and this is not even, it's not necessarily from the guy. Even as the lady said, yes, you need to have, at least you should be able to afford some things on your own. And as a guy, when you guys are together, like, just take yourself out, go on dates. Dinner dates, go and watch movies, and money is important, Sha. Money is important. And when we say money is important, you know there's this level for all humans. There's average, mm-hmm. there's poor, there's rich, there's
all humans,
there's wealthy. So if you are in the category of average, yes, you can afford average things and you guys will still enjoy yourself. Grow, yeah. If you are in the rich category, yes, you can afford luxuries to some extent and enjoy yourself. If you're in the wealthy category, yes, you can always afford these things and enjoy your relationship.
And lastly, money stop nonsense.
Hey, another thing is it proper to test a lady with money? Let me come in first. I've seen situations where a guy meets a lady that doesn't really, like, some ladies will not like a guy. And instead of telling the guy that they don't like it, because he has money, they just want to play around with the guy. It's not like they are serious. Some of them will say that, okay, I just want to collect this guy's money, I will not even get to see him. And because of the guy's normal nature of, the person is just the type that likes giving. And the person ends up spending on the girl, and at the end of the day, the girl breaks the guy's heart. Or even sometimes, guys are the ones that get to benefit from a rich girl, and mm-hmm. you end up breaking the girl's heart.
Mm-hmm.
You know that if this person meets another person,
mm-hmm.
and the person truly doesn't have that money, and the person loves the person, and it's not like he's trying to play the guy or the lady, you know, it will definitely affect the way even when the person has the money, the person will just be, they know feeling you. I'll test this person for like 2 months and see if this person actually likes me or is after my money. Is it right?
Well, the reason why you said that you want to test a lady or you want to test a guy, if you just see that spirit of being a gold digger, you can just use that as a test to know if that person is truly a gold digger or not.
How do you know that? See,
okay.
You said you want to test something. My point is, Someone that wants to test someone because it's possible to know if the person is a gold digger is because of the person's experience. The person has had an encounter with a gold digger before.
Mm-hmm.
So the best advice I think I can give is, well, if you know you don't like somebody genuinely,
don't stress
the person. Don't bother saying, okay, let me just chop this guy's money and clean mouth. I said in one of my videos, like, if you start learning how to love right, we can build our society with these things. I used to do it before. I'm not gonna lie. I can just try to deceive someone because you want to. You just collect money from someone. You're online. You collect money from the person and you don't end up deceiving the person. But let's stop all these things, because once you do it, you're giving the person, and people tend to generalize it. Like, you had an encounter with a lady that just came, a gold digger that just wants to chop your money and go. When you meet someone else, you won't be able to trust the person. Yeah, so the best way to tackle this thing is, don't, if you know you don't have anything to do with somebody, don't, because the person has money and you want to chop the person's money and go, just say no. It's better for you to just say no and allow the person to go in peace and meet someone that is ready and willing to stay with the person.
Yeah, Yoruba will say,
it's not easy because that money will enter your eyes. Exactly. But if you're not going to chop it, don't pass it.
Exactly.
So, and there's another thing.
Okay.
There's this issue that is always going on about Nigerian ladies always have transport fee.
Yeah.
But you know, I've been in that situation.
I was usually in 2K.
This, get out. My own was not the situation of 2K.
Okay.
It's not like I was getting along with someone. We are the talking stage.
Okay.
And we liked each other. Like, the likeness was there. We are not dating, but we're just trying to get to know each other. So, and that particular time, when now got time for us to meet, what's that we should meet?
Okay.
And that day, that very day, Koba 5 naira love me. Like, I didn't have money. So, you now imagine, like, and we like ourselves, like, the likeness was already there.
Mm-hmm.
Imagine, I was so confused, like, how would I even tell this person? And I don't, you know, if ladies like you, they can come and see you without
travel.
They can travel without even asking you for transport fee.
Exactly.
So the talking stage didn't work out because the person felt, I just wanted to collect, okay, 2K, get 3K and run away. And that was not the case. I liked the person, but I was not having money. People get broke now. I was not even working there. I was just
even the rich.
I was so broke, but the person was feeling like, okay, I like coffee work, but I offer barrel game to get coastal lunch. So I don't know. It's sometimes some people don't like, and even it can happen to a guy. You can have a boyfriend, and at that moment the guy does not have money. You guys are just covering yourselves secretly. Yes, you guys just brain. So it can happen to a guy. It can happen to a lady. It's not only ladies that don't have transport fee. Yeah. If you are dating someone that is going through financial crisis, it can happen. If you guys love yourself, you can make it work.
Exactly.
As long as you know that this person is not an alcohol, because some guys are stingy and some ladies are very stingy.
Well,
it's a red flag, though. If you are talking to someone and knows that this person is stingy, it's wrong.
Mm-hmm.
It's not even about you want to chop somebody's money or something. If you notice a lady and the lady can, someone, a lady has money and is not even willing to buy stuff for herself until you buy it for the person, it's a red flag. Mm-hmm. Well, if you are not around this kind of lady, she cannot even, like, you can't have financial crisis when you are married and she'll say, okay, let me
be an aid boss.
Yes. So stinginess is a red flag, though. And how do you even know if someone is stingy? We'll get to that stage. Now, to the next question.
Okay.
How important is getting, like, buying gifts for each other? How important is it in a relationship?
Yeah, gifting each other is very, very, very paramount. Gifting each other is like an hand of showing love. You know, when you gift your partner, it's an expression of valuing the person, like, how worthful the person is. Like, if you're just surprised with a little, I feel the person should be able to appreciate that you are even having her in your mind.
Yes, and the thing about gifting is not, shouldn't be limited to your boyfriend and girlfriend alone. Like, in this country, we don't like gifting ourselves. Like, even as friends, buy gifts for yourself. Like, girls, guys, Ladies, like, we don't really like gifts now. Well, I don't know, maybe because of my, some of my friends, yes, they like this gift and so. But I don't think it's not that common in this part of the world. It's only when you're dating somebody, you're like, okay, you want to surprise your boyfriend on his birthday, you want to surprise your girlfriend on her birthday. But gifting is not even, gifting should start with your friends. Like, gift to, you can support, like, it doesn't have to be something very, very expensive. You can go out and see a very nice card, like a card. Well, if you buy me a card, flower, I'll appreciate it. They used to say that Nigerian girls don't appreciate flower. It's not a difference. So gifting is very important in a relationship. Like, you can just go out and surprise your partner. Your partner might be saying, okay, and there's this thing I like. He or she might have been constantly saying it unconsciously that, okay, I like this. You can just go out and buy it for the person as a surprise. Like, that thing will just pack the chemical reactions that aids feelings in relationships. So it's very important to learn to gift your partner and gift your friends too, not just your partner. Make it an habit.
It's a spread of love.
Yes, it's a spread of love. Now, red flags in relationships. I think this red flagging is an elongated topic.
Yeah,
some people see red flags and still dive into that relationship. Like the one I was saying the other time, I said,
maybe something good might come out of
this. Yes, like for instance, this guy, when you have misunderstanding as a guy, as a lady, you're in a relationship, you notice that any slight misunderstanding, this guy will just start backing at you. Like the way we scream, even ladies say, some ladies are very violent. I've seen cases where ladies are the ones that they eat their partners. Like, it's not even about because she's a lady, you have to forgive her. It's not right. It's a red flag. Just leave the person. Like, if you're a guy, you're eating your girlfriend. If you're a lady and you're eating your guy, you guys should, it's better for you to run for your life, because the person that when you guys have misunderstanding, the person is yelling at you today, first step is slapping you. After the first lap, just run away. No matter, see, he might come back and bribe you with expensive gifts and say, my baby, no, you know I love you. Like buy expensive gift, take your expensive date. Run, no. It's a red flag. If your partner is violent, first time, second time, third time, run. Stinginess too. Stinginess. I'm not saying as a lady you should say, okay, this guy must give you money, as a guy, this girl must give you money.
Exchange.
But if you notice that this person has it, and he just doesn't, like, you know when someone is stingy now. There's a difference between, some people have that money, but there are things you don't know what we don't actually know what other people are going through.
Exactly.
There are some times that you have money and where the budget on the money itself gone.
It's beyond the money you have.
Yes, yeah, beyond the money. But when you know this person truly has money, like, you know your partner now, and the person cannot remove from the money, please run. Because when you get married, as I know some ladies are in marriages that their partners does not support them. Mm-hmm. Some people are married to a man that when they buy their car, it's from their own money. The husband cannot even surprise them with the car, and the husband can afford it.
Mm-hmm.
Some men are dating ladies that they are the ones paying the school fees, paying the house rent, paying everything.
The
ladies not supportive. This support is meant to come from both partners. Mm-hmm. It's not just from the guy. It's not just from the guy. So please. Stinginess is a red flag, in case you don't know. Stinginess is a red flag. When your partner when you use that this person is violent, just run.
Yeah,
like run. And if you're at the talking stage and you notice some bad traits that you can't cope with, it's not a sin when you just cut the person off. You have feelings for the person, yes, mm-hmm. but it's better you leave now, because by the time you guys start getting along, these are the things that will make you, it will make you lose interest.
Mm-hmm.
And so when you now leave the person, it's not be as well. Girl, she couldn't point out to something tangible, and she just ended the relationship like that.
No.
So when you see red flags, please just run. I can patch it. This person will change along the line. Please.
To just continue giving.
Run for your life. So we have come to the end of the second episode. Mm-hmm. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you learned from it. So don't forget to like and do this. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel. It's your only little way of supporting me.
Obrigado.
See you. Bye.
Thank you for watching. Please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share my videos.